Panlapan Yang introduces more exceptions to its freedom of information policy, among them information relating to national security, law enforcement, and public safety. It also classified birth, school, and medical records as information of personal nature, where disclosure would violate personal privacy. The program director of FOI Philippines, the lead agency for this initiative, explains the exceptions were not made to favor any individual.
Because these school records are personal information, and under Data Privacy Act of 2012, personal information is not disclosable to the public. Usually kasi no, yung public na may misunderstand nila no, how FOI works. So yung mga frontline services, minsan sa FOI nila nire-request, no, which should not be the case. So mga data, statistics, and other information na hindi po parte ng frontline service ng isang ahensya ang pwede po nilang i-request through the FOI.
The Philippine Central Bank delivers a 25 basis point hike as expected. This pushes the benchmark rate to 6.25%, the highest in nearly 15 years. But it appears to be hinting at a pause in rate increases as it expects lower inflation for this year and the next. Now it sees local inflation hitting 6% this year, lower than its previous 6.1 projection, while it will fall to the midpoint of the government's target range in 2024.
In the past, we were more or less sure that the next policy rate meetings will be another one, another increase. Now, clearly, now it really depends on the data. In the absence of new shocks, we think we are already moving in the right direction.
Meanwhile, BSP Governor Felipe Medalla again assured Filipinos the Philippine banking system is well insulated from the banking turmoil abroad.
No exposure, no or insignificant direct exposure of banks. And if people are exposed, it's their clients in the trust department, not the banks. So the banks, therefore, from the direct, simplistic point of view, walang impact. It hurt us, of course, if it becomes the repeat of 2008. But I don't think that will happen. The Fed has taken a lot of actions that will prevent that from happening.
A former operator of offshore gaming in the Philippines reveals a scheme involving the alleged selling of Chinese workers to other POGO firms. Nico Bawa has a special report.
October 19, 2021, the Philippine National Police entered the office of Benistar, a licensed POGO operator in Zapote, Las Piñas. According to Ruth Pomposelli, the former operator of the facility, the police were looking for six Chinese workers who were victims of human trafficking. But she was surprised when several other employees were made to leave the building and brought to the Las Piñas police station. She says the PNP did not show her any documents of the police operation.
Sabi ko, sir, nasaan po yung papel? Ano po yung pangalan ng reklamo? Ano po yung identity? Wala rin silang formal na binigay.
According to Pomposelli, ever since the police operation, she has never seen her employees. She says she was only able to track them when they were brought to the DSWD shelter in Mandaluyong. She was not able to get hold of the employees, and instead, she received a complaint for trafficking.
At hindi lang yun. You know what confused me? Nawawala yung mga tao ko. As in, nasaan? And then I found out na benta sa ibang POGO operator.
In a separate forum, Pomposelli says she tried to speak to some PNP officials so she can take back her employees. But she was asked to pay ₱500,000 for each employee.
Bago pumasok ang mga e-workers sa ibang employer, may utang na kaagad sila na 600,000.
Yun.
Yung mga workers na yan, pipiliti nilang magtrabaho.
Non-stop daw ito. Parang slave labor.
Yes, magiging slavery. Kung gusto mong umalis sa akin, lahat ng binayad ko sa'yo, lahat ng mga inano ko babayaran mo. Ngayon kung walang pambayad, tatawag sila sa pamilya na sa China, sa kaibigan. Kailangan mong bayaran yung ginastos.
The complaint against Pomposelli was eventually dismissed. However, she claims an official initially tried to ask 20 million from her for the case dismissal. The PNP denied her allegations.
That's very unfair to the PNP for her to accuse the PNP of doing that. Siguro he should start naming names so that these people that he will be naming, they can also defend themselves.
The ground commander in the raid explained that it was the Chinese embassy who sought for their assistance, and they were accompanied by the DSWD in the rescue operation to find the six trafficked Chinese workers. He claims the other employees of the POGO insisted that they be rescued as well, which is why they took them into custody.
Pagkakit namin, nung nagkakandak na inspection yung ating City Social Welfare and Development Officer, nagulat kami, yung mga empleyado nila, nagbabaan na at gusto nang umuwi. And na-overwhelm kami. Gusto nilang umuwi na at ayaw na nilang magtrabaho. So in-extend din namin yung aming tulong dito sa mga empleyado na to.
He also explained why Pomposelli was not allowed to speak to her employees.
Every time na nakikita nila yung mga yon, ng mga victims na na-rescue natin, bumabalik yung trauma nila. Sila mismo nagre-request na kung pwede, hindi sila makausap.
Pomposelli and the PNP also had a different headcount on the number of rescued workers that night.
58 lang siya talaga. So we have the records. We have dun sa police station, may records tayo. Hindi ko alam kung bakit niya sinasabing 72.
According to the DSWD, six of the employees escaped from their shelter. The remaining 52 workers were discharged last December 2021 and were brought to their relatives in Manila. The PNP doubts if the workers were sold after they were released, though they admit that this has happened in some cases.
All expenses paid ng company, yung accommodation mo, lahat sasagutin ng company. So siyempre, bilang investor, ang makabawi dun sa investment mo. Siguro kung hindi sila maging effective or hindi sila productive, para mabawi yung ginastos nila sa'yo, yun yung parang sigurong kanilang option.
According to the data gathered by the ABS-CBN Investigative and Research Group, out of the 111 victims in crimes involving POGOs from January 2019 up to September 2022, 71 were cases of kidnapping and 40 others were human trafficking. Majority of the victims are Chinese nationals. More than 80% were rescued by the police. The others paid ransom or escaped from their captors. This data does not include cases from other units from the PNP and the NBI. Kidnapping and trafficking aren't the only illegal activities that have involved POGOs. Others were involved in online scams. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Ombudsman orders the preventive suspension of 33 budget and health officials. They are tagged in the allegedly anomalous purchase of pandemic supplies from the controversial company, formerly Pharmaceuticals. Adrian Ayalin reports.
33 government officials led by former Procurement Service Department of Budget and Management Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau and former PSDBM Procurement Group Director Warren Rex Leong were put on a six-month preventive suspension by the Office of the Ombudsman. They are currently under investigation for the allegedly anomalous procurement of COVID-19 supplies at the height of the pandemic from formerly Pharmaceutical Corporation. Other PSDBM officials, as well as officials of the Department of Health and Research Institute for Tropical Medicine, were included in the order. According to the Ombudsman, there is overwhelming documentary proof that shows the respondents' evidence of guilt is strong. The respondents are facing administrative charges of grave misconduct, gross neglect of duty, serious dishonesty, and conduct prejudicial to the best interest of the service. The offenses, coupled with the seriousness of their participation, would warrant removal from service, according to the Ombudsman. A preventive suspension order will enable the Ombudsman to conduct an unhampered investigation to prevent those who are under probe from using their position to influence possible witnesses or tampering of vital records. In the statement of Leong read by his lawyer, he denied committing illegal acts as the transactions were in accordance with the Bayanihan to Heal as One Act, which exempted the transactions from the Government Procurement Reform Act.
Para klaro, hindi po ako kumita dito. Kaya ang hamon ko po ay ituro ng kinaukulan kung sino talaga ang mga kumita dito. Unfair na madamay ang mga inosenteng tao sa kasong ito.
Among the transactions mentioned in the order of the Ombudsman are three purchase orders for RT-PCR test kits from April to June 2020 under the Duterte administration, worth 2.877 billion pesos, 600 million, and 688 million pesos. The PSDBM under the Marcos administration said it respects the decision of the Ombudsman. The current leadership is also continuing to implement reforms as well as zero tolerance on irregularities and corruption. The DOH likewise respects the order as it vouched for the integrity of its officials who have been with the agency for a long time, aside from their significant roles in the country's COVID-19 response. While the DOH assured their cooperation in the investigation, they are also appealing to the public to reserve judgment until the investigation has been resolved. Senator Risa Ontiveros, who participated in the Senate formally investigation, said that the Ombudsman order bolsters the findings of the Senate against the suspended PSDBM officials.
Inaasahan din namin na magbubukas ng investigasyon sa issue ng PPEs at iba pang overpriced procurements. Sigurado ako na makikita natin ang mas malaking larawan pa, ang bigger or complete picture sa special audit ng COA.
She, however, hoped that high-profile names will also be investigated and not just employees and mid-level officials of government. Adrian Ayalin, ABS-CBN News.
Former Senate Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman Richard Gordon sees the Ombudsman decision as a vindication of their probe into the Health Department's pandemic procurement mess. Gordon hopes more people linked to the controversy will also be investigated by the Ombudsman.
Ang hindi niya nakikita rito ay yung mga iba, katulad ng Lin Wei Xiong, yun yung asawa ni Rose Nono Lim na nagtatago hanggang ngayon sa Dubai. Si Rose Nono Lim ang maraming kotseng babae, tumakbo pa ng congressman. At yun ang binigyan ng authority na itong Sir Dergani na kukunin yung pera na binabayad sa kanila, nagpapatunay na ang pera nilalabas sa bayan, nagpupunta sa mga ilang mga Chinese operations like Michael Young. Yan, ilalabas yan. Sigurado, may papel tayong hawak dyan.
Filipino authorities order a halt to the operations of the shipping company responsible for the massive oil spill affecting numerous coastal villages. The residents of these areas are bent on demanding compensation from the company's insurer. The details from Dennis Datu.
The Maritime Industry Authority orders RDC Real Marine Services, the company that owns the sunken MT Princess Empress, to stop its operations. The sunken vessel is responsible for the oil spill that is now affecting Oriental Mindoro and nearby areas.
We issued two cease and desist order. One is for a cancellation of the franchise or the CPC. The other one is for the to cease and desist in the operations.
The CPC is the license issued by Marina to ship operators to engage in domestic shipping activities. During an interagency meeting Thursday morning, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla revealed the oil slick from Oriental Mindoro is still heading towards the Verde Island Passage, known as the center of marine biodiversity in the world. Remulla calls the oil spill a big environmental crime.
This defines us as a country on how we really react to situations of this nature and how we resolve problems from our level. Nung nagpunta kami ng Pola, nung isang araw, nakita namin, niliparan namin yung extent ng oil spill. Nagsimula kami sa Verde Island Passage papuntang Pola at nakita namin talaga na papunta na sa Verde Island Passage.
Also in that meeting, the Environment Department said the owner of the sunken tanker may face an administrative fine of up to 471,000 pesos per day. Based on the DNR's inspection, 8 out of 10 areas in Region 6 where they took water samples had presence of oil. Government officials say they are employing a whole-of-government approach to solve the damage to environment and businesses.
We will find ways na makaharap tayo ng ma-arrest natin kagad yung oil spill.
Oriental Mindoro Governor Hormilito Dolor announced that starting Monday, business and tourism establishments and fishermen who lost their source of livelihood due to the oil spill can apply for compensation from PNI Club, the insurance company of MT Princess Empress.
Ay, sana naman matulungan kami nang pwedeng tumulong. Yung naman lang namin, yung counting, wag na napakarami, yung katamtamang kwarta, panggastos.
But the amount of the compensation will depend on the insurance company's evaluation.
Ilan ang huli ng isang fisherman sa isang araw? 3 kilo. Magkano niya binibenta yun? Baka 450 pesos. Ilan araw siya hindi nakahuli? As of today, 23 days. Di-multiply mo na lang, di ba? Abot yun siguro, konting kulang sa 10,000, right? Ganon ang computation.
Expenses related to the coastal cleanup can also be claimed as long as there are supporting documents.
Siguraduhin natin may official receipt. Siguraduhin may litrato. Mas magandang ebidensya. Siguraduhin natin na tayo ay hindi magpepeke ng dokumento kasi baka later on masayang yung buong claim.
Over 20,000 families were affected by the oil spill. The PNP conducted an aerial survey Thursday and though no spill was seen around Isla Verde in Batangas City, oil slicks were found floating in the seas facing Pola and Dauhan.
Nung una kasi southwest eh. Ngayon may mga indications na slowly ay pumipihit papunta ng northwest directions. Ito na yung Nauhan and then papunta ng Calapan.
Dennis Dato, ABS-CBN News, Oriental, Mindoro.